Hello kids, I am Priyanka and I am back with my new lecture, that is class 8 chapter 1, The Mysterious Picture. One child in the course of his wandering from court to court rode to the palace of Archduke of Battenberg on his donkey. His clothes and appearance attracted everyone's attention. उसने ऐसे clothes और उसका जो appearance था वो इतना अच्छा था कि हर किसी का attention वो attract कर रहा था. His cap was set smartly on his head. उसने बहुत style से अपने सर पे cap पहना था. And the three bright feathers on it danced as in the breeze as he rode. At the main entrance of the palace, the captain of the guard called out to him, "Hey there, you fellow on the donkey. You don't allow any loafers here." वो बोलते हैं जब मतलब गेट पे जब गार्ड्स उसको देखते हैं तो बोलते हैं कि ए सुनो जो डोंकी के ऊपर बैठे हुए हो यहाँ पे लोफर्स अलाउड नहीं है. यू एंड योर डोंकी ऑलरेडी लुक लाइक स्केलेटन. तुम और तुम्हारे डोंकी दोनों ही स्केलेटन की तरह दिखते हो. द कैप्टन ऑफ द गार्ड्स वॉज टॉल वेल बिल्ट रेड हेयर्ड मैन ऑफ अबाउट 25. जो कैप्टन था गार्ड का वो ऑलमोस्ट बहुत ज़्यादा टॉल था, वेल बिल्ट था. उसके जो बाल थे वो रेड थे और वो 25 ईयर्स का था. ही वॉज हैंडसमली ड्रेस्ड और वो बहुत ही अच्छे से ड्रेस्ड अप था. इन हिज गोल्ड ब्रेडेड यूनिफॉर्म टाइल लुक्ड एट हिम कूली एंड हिज डिसमाउंटेड फ्रॉम हिज डोंकी. वो उसको कूली देखता है और अपने डोंकी से उतरता है और उसको बो करता है, मतलब उसके सामने बो करता है, झुकता है. मे गॉड ब्लेस यू सर कैप्टन, इफ़ आई लुक लाइक ए स्केलेटन इट इज़ नॉट माई फॉल्ट. वो बोलता है कि अगर मैं एक स्केलेटन की तरह दिखता हूँ तो ये मेरा फॉल्ट नहीं है. इट्स जस्ट बिकॉज कि मैं बहुत हंगरी हूँ, मैं बहुत भूखा हूँ. आई हैव केम हेयर बिकॉज आई एम फोर्स टू. मैं यहाँ पर इसीलिए आया हूँ क्योंकि मुझे फोर्स किया गया है यहाँ पर आने के लिए. इफ़ यू विल बी सो गुड एज टू गिव मी अ पीस ऑफ गोल्ड कॉर्ड दैट यू वेयर ऑन योर कोट, आई विल गो एंड हैंग माई सेल्फ by the teeth of that large leg of mutton as I see hanging in the butcher shop. अगर आप मुझे एक गोल्ड कॉइन दे दोगे, एक पीस ऑफ गोल्ड कॉर्ड दे दोगे जो आपके कोट में है, तो मैं उसको लेके जाके जो बुचर शॉप है सामने वहाँ पर जाके दे दूँगा और एक बड़ा सा मटन लेग पीस खा लूँगा. द कैप्टन वॉज प्लेइंग गेम ऑफ चेस विथ अनदर ऑफिसर. जो कैप्टन था वो दूसरे ऑफिसर के साथ गेम खेल रहा था, चेस खेल रहा था. ही लुक क्यूरियसली एट टाइल. वो बहुत ही क्यूरियस होकर टाइल को देखता है. वेयर डू यू कम फ्रॉम, तुम कहाँ से आए हो. फ्रॉम फ्लैंडर्स रिप्लाइड टाइल. टाइल बोलता है मैं फ्लैंडर्स से आया हूँ. What do you want? तुम्हें क्या चाहिए. I should like to show His Highness the Archduke one of my painting. I am a painter. वो बोलता है मैं एक painter हूँ और मैं चाहता हूँ कि मैं Archduke को अपनी painting दिखाऊँ. Well, if you are a painter, if you come from Flanders, you may come in. अगर तुम एक painter हो और तुम Flanders से आए हो तो तुम अंदर जा सकते हो. Said the captain somewhat impressed. The captain knew that the Flemish painters and their pictures were in great demand all over the Europe. क्योंकि कैप्टन जानता था कि जो फ्लेमिश पेंटर है और वो जिनके पिक्चर्स है बहुत ज़्यादा डिमांड में है पूरे यूरोप में. टाइल वॉज प्रजेंटेड टू द आर्किड्यू. टाइल को आर्किड्यू के पास ले जाया गया. ही सल्यूटेड द आर्किड्यू थ्री टाइम्स एंड स्टूड बिफोर हिम विथ हिज हेड बोन. वो आर्किड्यू के पास गया, उसके सामने तीन बार बो करता है, झुकता है और अपना सर झुकाए हुए रहता है. May your highness pardon me for my rashness in thinking that one of my painting will please your highness. वो बोलता है कि मुझे माफ़ करना बट मुझे लगता है कि जो मेरी एक पेंटिंग है वो आपके हाइनेस को बहुत पसंद आएगी. I have bought a picture of your lady, the virgin in her royal robes. I have painted it specially so that it might lay it at your noble feet. Tile paused a few moments for his word to sink in. Then he continued, You must forgive me, your highness, if I have dared to hope that this picture will please you. अगर मुझे ऐसा लग रहा है कि आपको ये पिक्चर पसंद आएगी और अगर मैं ये बोलने का डेयर कर रहा हूँ तो प्लीज़ मुझे माफ़ करना. Perhaps your highness must wish to offer me a chair of your court. Painter who died recently. I can see the empty velvet chair waiting to be filled. The virgin picture was a splendid painting and the Archduke made up his mind at once. He embraced and kissed him on both cheeks. He said, I'll be delighted टू मेक यू एज माई कोट पेंटर, मैं बहुत खुश होऊंगा अगर आप हमारे लिए एज अ कोट पेंटर काम करोगे. ही डायरेक्टेड हिम टू द चेयर एंड मेड हिम सिट ऑन इट. उसने उसको वो चेयर के साइड दिखाया कि तुम जाके वहाँ पर बैठ सकते हो. वेल माई डियर फेलो ही सेड, यू डू यू हैव अ टंग इन योर हेड एंड यू सर्टेनली सीम टू नो हाउ टू यूज. यू आर वेरी टॉकेटिव फेलो आंट यू. योर हाइनेस मे प्लीज यू टू रिमेंबर मी एंड माई डोंकी. जेफ फॉर जस्ट वन मिनट, टाइल रिप्लाइड, माई डोंकी हैज़ बीन फीडिंग हिमसेल्फ फेयरली well all along the way on the thorns in his hedge and the grasses on the roadside, but I had nothing to eat for the past 3 days. वो बोलता है कि जो मेरा डोंकी है वो तो थॉर्न्स और हेजेस से ग्रासेस खाते आ रहा था पूरे रास्ते, बट मैंने पूरे 3 दिन से कुछ भी नहीं खाया है. मेरा स्टमक बहुत कंप्लेन कर रहा है लाउडली. परहैप्स योर हाइनेस कैन इवन Hear it now. I have been feeding myself with dream of good food and drinking at your royal table. बोलता है मैं तो सिर्फ इतने टाइम से ड्रीम ही कर रहा था कि मैं आपके मतलब रॉयल टेबल में खाना खा रहा हूँ और पानी पी रहा हूँ. The Akidu smiled and said, "Well, my dear fellow, you will certainly have something more solid than dream to feed on. Where is your donkey? तुम्हारा donkey कहाँ है? I left him outside opposite the palace. I shall be most grateful if Jeff is looked after. He need a little fodder and lodging at night, said Tile. The Arcady immediately ordered the donkey to be taken care of as he added, treat it like one of my own animal. Before long supper was served at it was like a feeding wedding fest. The table was loaded with every kind of food and drink. Wine flowed like water. The courtiers stuffed themselves with choicest dishes. The Arcady made Tile eat and drink until his stomach was about to burst. The Arcady too ate heartily. His face was flushed with drink, but he seemed lost in thought. He suddenly looked up and said loudly, "Our court painter must paint our portrait so that we will have the satisfaction of living our memory in the descendants. We too have to take our place in history along with our noble ancestors. While portraits adorn these walls, it is said to think of death. We do not know when God will think fit to summon us, but our portrait should be painted." वो बोलता है कि हमारी पोर्ट्रेट पेंट होनी चाहिए. Tile quickly replied, "Your lordship sight wished is to my demand. All the same, I do rather unhappy about painting your lordship all by yourself. It's not terrible to think of your lordship being loyal for ever and ever. Do you think ladies and gentlemen and his highness should be accompanied at least by your highness, her ladies, the noble general and the captains who adorn his court? A coat like this has a few rivals in splendors, loveliness, and chivalry. In the midst of such velvet and beauty, I will make my lord and lady shine forth like the mouth surrounded by lanterns." The Arcady bought that. It was a good idea. "Well, my friend, your painting will be a great piece of art. What reward do you want to expect for it? 100 pieces of gold. You can pay me now or later, just as you please. Here are the 100 pieces of gold in advance," said the Arcady, giving him the gold. "My lord, you are the most generous of master. You have filled my lamp with oil. I will forever burn in your honor." The next day, Tile asked the Arcady to allow him to see the courtiers who were to be painted along with him. They came and saw him one by one, the first one to come with the commander-in-chief of the army. He was a short, fat, bald man with an enormous paunch. He whispered in the Tile ear, "When you paint my picture, remember you are to make me look handsome. If you do look my stomach fat, I'll have you hanged. Remember, I was once a handsome soldier." An elderly lady came next. She had a large hump on her back. "Sir Painter," She said softly, "Make me look young and beautiful. If you don't remove the hump on my back and supply what I lack in the beauty, I will have you torn to pieces." A young lady who was a companion of the Duchess came in as soon as the old lady left. She was young and pretty, but had lost 3 of her front teeth in the accident. She warned Tyle that if in her picture she didn't see herself smiling with a perfect set of pearly teeth, she would give him a cut into small bites by her lovers. She pointed to the captain of the guard. Similarly, the request of and threats continued. ऐसे बहुत सारे request और threats उसको बार बार सुनाई देने लगे, मतलब लोग आके उसको बोलने लगे. Until he had finished with the last of his courtiers, and the Arquiduc sent for him and said, "My dear fellow, I want your portrait to be perfect in every detail. You are to paint my courtiers exactly as we see them. If you leave out a mole, a pimple, or a single grey hair, I'll have you slaunted like a pig." Tyle coolly thought things over and said to himself, "If I paint this picture, I shall certainly be killed. Either the Duke will have me slaunted like a pig for having disobeyed him, or the courtiers will have made me murder for painting them what they really are." Tyle सोचने लगा, अगर मैं इन्हें पिक्चर बना देता हूँ तो मैं मतलब सर्टनली मेरे को मार दिया जाएगा. अगर मैंने आर्कड्यूक के हिसाब से सेम पिक्चर एज इट इज़ जैसे लोग हैं वैसे नहीं बनाया तो वो मुझे बहुत मारेंगे. और अगर मैंने कोर्टियर्स के हिसाब से अगर उनके रियल पिक्चर बना दिया तो फिर कोर्टियर्स मुझे मार डालेंगे. इन आइदर केसेस आई एम टू डाई, दोनों केसेस में मेरे को मरना ही है. व्हाट एम आई टू डू, अब मैं क्या करूँ? परहैप्स इट इज़ वाइजर नॉट टू पेंट दिस पिक्चर एट ऑल, अच्छा होगा अगर मैं ये पिक्चर ना ही पेंट करूँ. तो वो सोचता है कि अगर मैं इन सबसे बचने का एक ही उपाय है कि अगर मैं ये पिक्चर ही पेंट ना करूँ तो मुझे ये सारे प्रॉब्लम्स फेस नहीं करने पड़ेंगे, क्योंकि अगर पिक्चर में ज़रा भी कुछ ख़राब हुआ तो आर्कड्यूक बोलेगा, और कोर्टियर्स का कुछ ख़राब बना तो कोर्टियर्स बोलेंगे. ओके, द फॉलोइंग डे ही आज द आर्कड्यूक फॉर द हॉल वेयर ही वॉज टू पेंट द पिक्चर. नेक्स्ट डे उसी दिन क्या हुआ कि आर्कड्यूक उसने बोला कि कौन से हॉल में उनको पिक्चर पेंट करनी है. ही वॉज शोन अ लार्ज रूम विद बेयर वॉल्स, उसको एक बड़ा सा रूम दिखाया गया एक खाली दीवार से. और उसने टाइल ने मतलब उनको बोला गया, टाइल आस्क्ड फॉर थिक कर्टन टू बी हंग ऑन द वॉल्स. काइल ने बोला एक बड़ा सा थिक कर्टन इस वॉल में हंग कर दो. ही वॉन्टेड हिज पेंटिंग टू बी प्रोटेक्टेड फ्रॉम द फ्लीज एंड डस्ट, वो चाहता है कि उसकी जो पेंटिंग है वो फ्ली और डस्ट से कवर्ड रहे. ही ऑल्सो आस्क्ड फॉर 3 असिस्टेंट्स टू हेल्प हिम इन मिक्सिंग कलर्स. द आर्किटेक्ट गेव हिम ऑल ही आस्क्ड फॉर. For 30 days, Tyle and his assistant feasted themselves at the choicest dishes and drank the finest wine. On the 30th day, the Arquiduc thrust his nose in through the door and said, "It is time that you finish the painting. I am eager to see it. It's ready. Is it ready? Kya ye picture ready hogi?" Tyle said. The picture was being completed and that he needed some more day to finish it. Picture complete hi hone wali hai. Mujhe thoda sa kuch aur din chahiye picture ko complete karne ke liye. The architect replied that as long as the painting was perfect in every detail, he was prepared to be patient. The delay of a week or two did not matter, he said. Tyle and his companion continued their merrymaking for another fortnight. On the 45th day, once again, the architect poked his nose in through the door. "Isn't it the time that the picture was completed?" he asked. Tyle said that the portrait was being given the finishing touches. He begged for some more time. The architect said that this delay did not matter so as long he did an excellent job, but he added, "You should either complete the picture within 50th day or you should show me the unfinished picture now." Tyle promised to complete the picture within 15 days, saying that only a few minor details remained to be filled in. "Should your lordship see the painting now, you would not be satisfied with it," he said. Tyle and his companions enjoyed themselves for another fortnight. On the 60th morning, the architect forced him way into the room and said, "I must see the picture at once. Where is the picture? Draw the curtain apart." "The picture is ready, my lord," announced Tyle. "Then why don't you draw the curtains? What's the matter?" the architect asked. I want you to grant me one last favor, said Tile. Please order all the courtiers assembled in this room. When they are, I want to say a few words to them and then I'll draw the curtains. The architect ordered all the courtiers to assemble in the hall. Tile addressed them. My lord, ladies and gentlemen, the picture is ready. You will now be able, as I draw the curtains, to see how well I am done with my work. You can all admire my work, but I must warn you, there is something very special about this picture. One those among who has noble blood in your veins will be able to see the painting. जिसके मतलब blood में nobleness होगा, सिर्फ वही इस painting को देख पाएगा और बाकी को कुछ भी नहीं दिखेगा. All the rest, whatever their rank or position, will see nothing but a blank wall. Now I'll draw the curtains. Tile falling the curtain aside. The courtiers outdid one another in showing their admiration for the pictures. They praised Tile for a splendid painting. They remarked how natural each one they looked in the picture and eagerly pointed out their friends and acquaintances. All of a sudden, the Duke gestured, leaped into the air and shouted, "All of you know that I am a fool and I have no blue blood lines in my veins. I can see no picture but a blank wall." When fool began to talk, observed Tile, "It's time for wise men to walk." He calmly strode out the wall and rode away on his donkey. The feather in his cap danced in the gentle breeze. And that was all about this chapter. I hope you liked it. Thank you.